Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Aidun Sa'id, kullu aam wa antum bakhair. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Walillahi alhamd. Allah is the greatest, Allah is the greatest. There is no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the greatest, Allah is the greatest, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all praise is due. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the assembler of the multitudes again and again, the eliminator of nations and armies. Praise be to the one who will gather us again on the day of resurrection, about which there is no doubt. My brothers and sisters, I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah's servant and his messenger. Allah's messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is favored by Allah's favors above all human beings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
bless our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless his family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all those who are on the right path shown by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters, before I say something, I advise you and first of all myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on account of his favors that he has bestowed upon us today and every day, today and tomorrow, and whatever life he has given us. My brothers and sisters, among the favors that he has bestowed upon us is the day of Eid al-Fitr, which we are celebrating today. Among the favors that he has given us, the month of Ramadan that he has bestowed upon us, and we are celebrating today the completion of that month. In the month we fasted, in the month we stood in prayers, in long prayers in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and these are among the greatest favors that Allah has given to us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your needs and my needs. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to overlook our mistakes and our faults which we might have committed in this holy month of Ramadan. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous of all those who show generosity. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most benevolent of all those who show benevolence. Today we are celebrating Eid al-Fitr. At the same time, we are saying farewell to the month of Ramadan. My brothers and sisters, while standing today in front of you on the day of Eid, this time in this masjid, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his all favors. You know that yesterday it was the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan started. It came quickly and it has gone quickly. It looked as if it started only yesterday. And today we are celebrating this day, the festival of fast breaking. There are lessons that we must learn from the month of Ramadan, my brothers and sisters. The month of Ramadan should teach us about the temporary nature of the life of this world. Today we are here, and tomorrow we will be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our accounts. When we are in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we look back at our deeds, what we perform in this worldly life, this life would be, my brothers and sisters, like a dream. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the glorious Quran, where he says, وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ كَأَنْ لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا إِلَّا سَاعَةً مِنَ النَّهَارِ يَتَعَارَفُونَ بَيْنَهُمْ. And on a day when he shall gather them together, it will be as if they had no state in the life of this world and grace, but an hour of a day. They will recognize each other. My brothers and sisters, similarly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions In the glorious Quran, كَأَنَّهُمْ يَوْمَ يَرَوْنَ مَا يُعَدُونَ لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا إِلَّا سَاعَةً مِنَ النَّهَارِ. On the day of resurrection, when they see that torment with which they were promised in the worldly life, with that torment with which they were threatened in this worldly life, it will be as if they had not stayed more than an hour in a single day. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, كَأَنَّهُمْ يَوْمَ يَرَوْنَهَا لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا إِلَّا عَشِيَّةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا. The day they see it, it will be as if they had not tarried in this world except an afternoon or a morning. يَوْمَ يُنْفَقُ فِي الصُّورِ وَنَحْشُرُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ يَوْمَئِذٍ زُرْقًا يَتَخَافَتُونَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِن لَّبِثْتُمْ إِلَّا عَشْرًا. The day when the trumpet will be blown, that day we shall gather the criminals blue-eyed. They will speak in a very low voice to each other, saying, you stayed not longer than 10 days. We know very well what they will say when the best among them in knowledge and wisdom will say, you stayed no longer than a day. My brothers and sisters, it will be like a dream. So this worldly life is like a dream, and you will recognize, we will recognize this when we are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today this assemblage, this gathering here today in Al-Farooq Masjid remind us the day of resurrection, when we will be raised from our graves and we will be called for our accounts, for our deeds which we did in this worldly life. When we will meet to Allah, our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for reckoning, and we will be barefooted, naked, with eyes staring fixedly in horror, about which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the glorious Quran, يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. The day you shall see that every nursing mother will forget her nursling, and every pregnant one will drop her load, and you shall see mankind as in a drunken state, yet they will not be drunken, but severe will be the torment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This day of gathering reminds us of the day when the brother will be fleeing from his brother, from his parents, from his friends, from his sons and children, my brothers and sisters. This day reminds us of the day when the records will be given in the hands of people. Good people will be given their records in their right hand, and bad people will be given their records in their left hand. My brothers and sisters, remember those who were here last year with you, who prayed with you, who were praying Eid al-Fitr with you last year, but today you cannot find them here. They have gone. They have met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should remember those who are suffering all over the world, who are suffering from the ravages of foods and all other natural calamities. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower His mercy, His blessings upon all of them, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most beneficent Lord who grants them relief and shower His blessings upon them. We are living, my brothers and sisters, in this difficult time, and you can see that everywhere Muslims are worried about their conditions in this worldly life. There are times about which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described as the times of fitan, the times of crisis, that the crisis will come after one after another. Crisis will shake the faith of human beings, and crisis will test our patience, and these are the days we are facing. In these difficult times, Muslims need to keep alive the spirit and lessons, and they should get lessons from the month of Ramadan. A lesson of self-restraint, a lesson of patience. They should get the lesson of forbearance. They should get lesson of compassion. And my brothers and sisters, in these difficult times, we are facing several challenges. We are facing today the challenge of ignorance. We are facing today the challenge of extremism. We are facing today the challenge of alcoholism. And we are facing today the challenge of aggression and oppression. My brothers and sisters, We know that Islam is peace, yet you will find the actions of Muslims that they are otherwise, they are against peace. You know that Islam is mercy, but you will find Muslim brothers and sisters that there are those who never hesitate to kill each other. We say that Islam is a discipline and self-restraint, yet you will find that it is easy for us to become impatient. My brothers and sisters, our children today need to be educated in morals. Our children today need to be educated in characters. Our children today need to be educated in Islamic values. Our children today need to make themselves exemplars of mercy and compassion. And we need to teach them values and principles. We need to nurture them according to the teachings of Islam, according to the ways shown by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that they can be the leaders who will be standing forth as witness of justice and compassion for all humanity. And this is what the glorious Quran commands us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kunu qawwamina lillahi shuhada bil qist wa la yajrimannakum shana'an qawmin ala alla ta'dilu اعدلوا هو اقرب للتقوى واتقوا الله ان الله خبير بما تعملون. Or you who attain to faith, be ever steadfast in your devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bearing witness to the truth in all equity, and never let hatred of anyone lead you into the sin of deviating from justice. Be just. This is closest to being God conscious, and remain conscious of God. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of all that you do. My brothers and sisters, we are the world, we are humanity, we are community, and we all are the members of that. We are for peace, we are for tolerance, and we are for patience. So we must practice all these things in our life. This is the message with what that I would like to share with you today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the glorious Quran has mentioned, Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha, wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu, inna akramakum indallahi atqakum, inna Allah alimul khabir. O mankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female, and we made you into nations and tribes that you may know each other. Verily, the most honorable of you with Allah is the believer who has taqwa in his heart. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-knowing and all-aware. And my brothers and sisters, with a few more words I would like to end my talk today, that this is the time which must teach people that Islam is the religion that means peace, that stands for peace, and that teaches people to be peaceful in their life through justice and through compassion. That we believe in a Quran that is opposed to aggression. The Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that was given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is a guide for us. Quran teaches us and calls us for saving lives. It teaches us to save the earth, and it protects the environment, and it teaches us to do good things in this worldly life. Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that preserves the truth of all previous scriptures. It enhances and guards the truth revealed to all the prophets. The Quran does not teach us to impose our religion on anyone or to oppress anyone. It is the principle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, the principle of freedom of conscience, which is deeply mentioned in the glorious Quran. And at the end, I pray for you, for myself, for all the brothers and sisters, for all the brothers and sisters who have passed away, for all the brothers and sisters who are today here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your servants have come to this place seeking your reward and bounty and fearing your punishment. Allah, fulfill our wish and make us secure against that which we fear, and gather us on the word of truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make smooth for us the path of bliss and save us from the path of misery. Give us good in this worldly life and the good in the hereafter. For you are the most generous and most bounteous. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'd like to say first, Ramadan Kareem is gone, but Eid Sa'id for all of you, and I wish this Eid will bring all the happiness and prosperity for your family, children, wife, grandchildren, mothers, father, all of you will be in good shape, all of you. I would like at the same time ask for Allah to bring all our Muslim community in one heart, whatever differences we have. There are 33 nationalities in this mosque, and the differences are normal. Even with the time of Prophet Muhammad and Khulafa Rashidin, there were differences. But these differences should be converted to a love and unity for all Muslim brothers, you know. And I ask for Allah and from you prayers for especially the Somalis who are dying from hunger. Their children really are dying from thirst and hunger. Your donation is appreciated. And I ask from Allah at the same time to protect all Muslim brothers and sisters and their children here and overseas. And I pray for Allah for their safety here and overseas. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Every year, mashallah, we see many new brothers and sisters joining us in Salat. Many of you who have not been here do not know that the masjid started in 1980. This was a small place right here, and that masjid, with the help of and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the participation of the community has now grown to this. But I just want to bring to your attention some of the activities that happen in the masjid. The masjid itself, and since this new building opened, alhamdulillah, about 6,500 non-Muslims have come here and have listened to the message of Islam and have listened to the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have a school which has pre-K to 8th grade. It has 250 students. That facility is available to you. You can register the child there, and the fee is about one-third that of another private school. We have a Darul Uloom, mashallah, HIFS program, in which there are about 70 students, and we have had just a graduation ceremony of others. That program is also available, and now, alhamdulillah, the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have renovated the old church that we had before into a new housing quarters for the Darul Uloom. We have also now plans to build a gymnasium here to expand the school to high school level. So inshallah, the plans for the gymnasium are under construction. The plans from the city and the zoning board have been approved. So with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mashallah, activities are going on. You can be a part of that movement. You can be a part of the future of the Muslim community. You can be a part, as the Imam said, of building the future generations here by participating in the Islamic activities. You can do so in many ways. Attend the programs. There is a HIFS program, there is the Sunday program, there is the Arabic teaching classes, there is the Alim course, there are new Muslim courses, and all those things are going on. Be a part of it. If you cannot be physically be a part of it, at least support it financially and with your dua. Financially, there are three things outside, of course, Sadaqatul Fitr, which is $7 per person. We have also some donations to the masjid. As you know, these activities cost money. And then there is a box for the Somalian refugees also. As you know, the brother Tome mentioned, that they are in need as well. So please take part. You can visit our website, ul-Fitr.org, ul-Fitr.org, and you will see all the list of our activities, YouTube presentations of all the programs, as well as opportunities to go and address the donate through PayPal. So please, my dear brothers and sisters, welcome to Al-Farooq Masjid. be a part of the activities, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all the Siyam and the Qiyam and the and Eid al-Fitr. Please move forward now.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Eid Sa'id, Eid Mubarak, kullu aam wa antum bi khayr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our Siyam, our Qiyam, our recitation of Quran in the month of Ramadan. And today we have gathered here to seek the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to show a sign of gratitude towards the Almighty that He had kept us alive, that He had given us an opportunity to win His pleasure, to get the rewards in both the worlds, in this worldly life and in the world hereafter. And today we are gathered here together so that we can thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His immense blessing and mercy He had showered upon us in the month of Ramadan. And today, inshallah, we'll make a promise with ourselves that the rest of the year we live a life in accordance with the teaching of Quran and the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In a short while, we are going to start Salat al-Eid. This is the first Eid of the two. First is Eid al-Fitr and the second is Eid al-Adha. Eid al-Fitr is followed by Ramadan. And this Eid is, as I said, that a sign of gratitude towards our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the method is simple. Though this is Eid and we must remember the method of Eid, but it comes only twice a year. So most of the Muslim brothers and sisters tend to forget the method of offering Salat al-Eid. So I will briefly mention the method of Eid. Make a niyah of two rakat, Salat al-Eid al-Fitr, behind the Imam. And after saying the takbir, fold your hands. Say Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdika wa tabaraka ismuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruk.
The sister said, if you bring it close by to your mouth, closer, they hear better.
And after saying the Subhanakallahumma, the Imam will say the takbir three times. Follow him, and each time raise your hands up to your ears and drop them. After first takbir, raise your hands and drop them. After second takbir, raise your hands and drop them. After the third takbir, raise your hands and fold them. The Imam will start the qira'ah, Surah Al-Fatiha and another surah. And the Imam will complete the first rak'ah and he will start the second rak'ah as normally. And after the qira'ah in the second rak'ah, before he goes to ruku', he will say three takbirs. Each time, raise your hands and drop them. Three takbirs. And after saying the fourth takbir with the Imam, go to the ruku. These are six additional takbirs which are wajib, obligatory to pronounce in this salah. Six takbir, three takbirs in the first rakah before the Imam starts the recitation. And in the second rakah after the Imam finishes his recitation before he goes to ruku, three takbirs. So three takbirs in the beginning rak'ah, in the beginning of the recitation, and three takbirs in the second rak'ah after the completion of the recitation, before you go to ruku', inshallah. Now, stand inshallah, make yourself, fill up the gaps, make room for others who are standing outside, accommodate your brothers and sisters. After the salah, inshallah, the Imam will deliver the khutbah. So listen to the khutbah peacefully, inshallah, Mulaziz. Complete each saf properly. Don't make any rooms, don't create any gap in between. Try to accommodate your brothers who are standing behind. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين لا أقسم بهذا البلد ووالد وما ولد لقد خلقنا الإنسان في كبد أيحسب أن لن يقدر عليه أحد يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا أيحسب أن لم يره أحد ألم نجعل يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا متربة ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة أولئك أصحاب الميمنة والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة عليهم نار مؤصدة الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر 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 كبيرا والحمد لله بكرة وأصيلا الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون الحمد لله الذي سخر الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر كلهم في فلك يسبحون وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة تنفع العبد يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين الذي تنقطع فيه المنون الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد أيها المسلمون ها قد رحل عنا شهر الجود والكرم شهر الصيام والقيام والقرآن شهر البر والجود والإحسان إن يومكم هذا يوم عظيم وعيد كريم في هذا اليوم يفرح الذين جدوا واجتهدوا في رمضان في هذا اليوم يفرح المصلون ويندم المسالى النائمون العابثون اللاعبون الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد إن الجوائز الإلهية اليوم ما هي إلا جزء من الجوائز العظيمة الذي يخص الله بها عباده الصائمين يوم القيامة قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله عز وجل للصائم فرحتان يفرحهما إذا أفطر فرح وإذا لقي ربه فرح بصومه هذا جزاؤك وهذه هديتك وهذا قدرك سمعت أمر ربك فأخذته قرأت كتابه فالتزمته عرفت رسوله فاتبعته فكان جزاؤك أعظم جزاء الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد أيها المسلمون ما أعجل العيد وما أعظم آثاره وما أكثر مقاصده وحكمه وأسراره فالعيد لا تتم فرحته ولا تتحقق فضيلته ولا تشع بهجته إلا بإبراز ملامح المودة والتعاضد إن العيد صورة بهية مشرقة فاجعلوه فرصة للتزاور فيما بينكم ومحطة لغرس مبادئ الحب في قلوبكم حيث قال جل شأنه في حديثه القدسي وجبت محبتي للمتزاورين فيا إن من حقوق الأخوة أن نكون متحابين مختلفين متحدين يعامل كل منها على غرض ما ينفعه في دنياه ودينه فقد قال الله عز وجل وتعاملوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاملوا على الإثم والعدوان واتقوا الله إن الله شديد العقاب الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه يغفر لكم إنه هو الغفور الرحيم الله أكبر 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 الحمد لله كبيرا والحمد لله بكرة واصيلا الحمد لله العزيز الحميد ختمنا شهر رمضان بهذا العيد السعيد وأنزل لنا فيه من الثواب والعتاب وهو الكريم المجيد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين أما بعد فلقد مر بنا شهر رمضان مر بخيراته وبركاته ونسأل الله أن يبارك فيما كان فيه من خير وأن يتجاوز عما كان فيه من تقصير وأن يتقبل صيامنا وقيامنا أيها المؤمنون إن العامل لا يفكر في العيد بقدر تفكيره وإهتمامه بقبول الله عمله فنسأل الله تعالى أن يتقبل عملنا وعملكم وصيامنا وصيامكم الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد إن من أعظم علامات قبول العمل في رمضان التوبة النصوح من جميع الذنوب الماضية والعزيمة الصادقة على الاستقامة على الطاعة في الأيام القادمة أسأل الله تعالى أن يجعلنا من المقبولين وأن يقدمنا بخير وأن يجمعنا على خير هذا وصلوا وسلموا على إمام المرسلين فقد أمركم الله تعالى بالصلاة والسلام عليه حيث قال عز وجل قائلا عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين وعن المؤمنين والمؤمنات إلى يوم الدين وأنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تدع فينا ولا معنا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم إنا نسألك أن ترزق كل منا لسانا صادقا ذاكرا وقلبا خاشعا منيبا وعملا صالحا زاكيا وعلما نافعا رافعا وإيمانا راسخا ثابتا ويقينا صادقا خالصا ورزقا حلالا طيبا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين ووحد اللهم صفوفهم وأجمع كلمتهم على الحق وابقوا بالسلام والأمن لعبادك أجمعين. اللهم انصر الإسلام في كل مكان. اللهم انصر جماعة الموحدين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم واغفر من فضل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. تقبل الله منا ومنكم وكل عام وأنتم بخير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.